It's time for what?
Experience in college.
Where nothing is impossible unless you think it is impossible.
College scholarship.
Yes.
Mom.
College ran by real fast.
You hung in with the best college.
Touchdown!
Let's do this thing.
Genius, let's do this thing!
Before I do my introduction, I think let's just get that moment. Just those deep breaths, we all need it, whether it's an exciting day or a tiring day. And I'm going to say a simple thing that I say to with my children every day. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And why I say that, because one thing we can't change is sometimes there are certain policies and things in the world we can't. But the one thing that your beautiful student can is change what options that are available for them, whether to keep steady and keep fast in that motion or look at other things that they never thought about. And I want to make sure to introduce stuff to you, but today we don't have any agenda. You are the agenda, your questions, but it's really about answering your questions. So we are truly with you. But why listen to me? Back in the days, I worked at, oh my God, back last century, not exaggerating, many different colleges and high schools, public, private, the graduate program at UCSF, UC Berkeley, worked at the community college. And if you can't tell, I love working with my high school students. And it was an alum who introduced to me about the Magis program. When I got hired, I was told you have to get involved in the Magis. And I have not stopped over a decade. And I'm so, so grateful. Thank you for this opportunity to serve you, to help you. And just to let you know, the information I give to you, if I think it's a professional opinion, I will let you know. If it's something that I'm like, oh no, this is the deal, and you're like, prove it to me, I will show you. I'm always about black and white because there's a lot of opinions out there, and that's okay to listen to it. But when we're applying for a scholarship, an internship, or a volunteer opportunity, or a college, we need to address, you know, what they want, what they need, not what the hearsay is. But one of the things is that I had to take a deep breath. I had to do a serenity prayer. For doing this for over 3 decades, I had to say, wow, I've never seen so many changes in one admissions year. So let's talk about the changes that are starting with the class of 24 all the way to our beautiful class of 27. The big one that let's talk about what I'm really excited about is that TAFSA optional is not going away. What does that mean? If you all had to take some standardized tests for your students to come to St. Ignatius, well, guess what? Having tests on college applications are not required right now for the class of 24 for over 2,000 schools. 2,000 schools. That's a lot. 80 of them. And a lot of them just in California are test free, meaning even if you have a perfect test score, they won't accept that. Now, maybe you have that kid that's always 90th percentile, 80th percentile in math or language arts. Well, for the schools that say you could take the test or not, that's an option. And that's why SI on October 11th, the sophomores will be taking one of those practice tests called the ACT. So, and that will be a paper exam. And then the second one that the juniors, the class of 25 will be taking is the brand new, take a deep breath, digital PSAT. Again, it's practice. Again, if you're thinking about going to a UC, Cal State, Columbia University, an Ivy League school, Vassar, a school that meets full need in upstate New York, they're staying forever. Test optional or test free. So you do not need to worry about those whatsoever. So that's something that's really, really important. I got a question. Let's see what the question is. Can you please share with students in the Magis program, perhaps for the class of 22, 23? You mean like, where have they gone? So let's kind of look at a scattergram. And then I know there's other questions. So what is that scattergram? So if you're the class of 27, please know that we have a student information system to help them with college. And this is a parent view on there. Right now, class of 24, parents, guardians, you should be on this. You should know this. It's okay if you don't. Ask those questions away. If you are part of the class of 25, juniors, parents, you have this. And by the way, if you scroll down, everyone, look, you won't see here what colleges are coming. So if you have a junior or a senior, please say, hey, can I see your score homepage? This is a homepage. What colleges are coming in September? Because they come only for about 2 months. And then that's it. And they come to St. Ignatius during their upper lunch and after school. So sophomores, yes, freshmen, even freshmen can check out some schools coming to our campus. But I didn't answer the question. How do I see the admission rate for some of these schools? All right, let's go look. So let's look at UC Santa Cruz. So everything here you could click. Just know that if you're on the parent view, some of it's not available on the iPad, right? So this is just messages, information that you as parents can kind of help with the student. But if you're like, wait a minute, I want to see that graph. I just put on the search button a campus. Here is a beautiful campus, UC Santa Cruz. We have a handful of our Magis students over there. And then if I go to the admissions page, and then don't worry, after I go here, freshmen and sophomore parents, I'll show you another resource from our federal government. It's a little bit different, but just as useful. So here I get to see how many majors, how hard it is for everyone who applied to the campus, how many students have aid. Remember, this is just, the tuition. Believe it or not, living on campus, paying for their food for the dorm is actually more expensive. Shows you the location. Other campuses that SI students have also applied to. So you can see the UCs are very popular because they're pretty affordable in a sense of maybe not the sticker price, but they're very affordable if you apply for financial aid. And then here's academics like majors, different programs, where most people study. So a lot of people think most people are just doing all STEM, right? Like marine biology, stuff like that. And no, it's actually social sciences. That's where a lot of students are studying at UC Santa Barbara. This is not SI data. This is just for everyone who's applied over there that the colleges have provided. How much is the charge? Hey, what if my household income was approximate, I would pay? How big's the school? It's a large school. It's not unusual. It's 600 in the classroom, right? That's why the retention rate, the percentages that come back, 9% don't because it's such a large campus. And this shows you the diversity of the students, diversity of where states everyone's coming from, and then also the gender and other different programs as well. But you're like, but that first question, show me the data. All right, I'll show you. So what I'm going to do is, and the students have the same, if you go to the admissions and then you go into view scattergram, the student has a preset, I think it goes all the way to 22, but let's just see what happened. Someone asked me like what happened with the class of 22 who applied to UC Santa Barbara as one example. You could see this is all SI students. So you could see the green means where they've been accepted, blue is waitlisted, red is challenged. Not the easiest school, even though it's a public school that's in state. So that's something that's important to be able to see. I do know there's another question. Okay, how do colleges compare students who have taken tests versus those who haven't? Is there any biases if you've taken a test or not? We have a lot of podcasts, YouTube videos stating all that information. No, it's not. So let's go look at an actual college application. When a student fills out, this is an application that goes to 1,000 schools nationwide, not including the UCs and Cal States. And when they do testing, they just say, are you taking it or not? Now, this person said yes. Let's say they took AP Spanish. Maybe they took another AP test. So like juniors have the option to take AP English language if they're good at writing. Colleges will still look at that, but there's no penalties. You really have to think of a test score as an activity. So a student doesn't go in one pile who taken the test and another kid has another pile who has not. You have to think of test scores as basically, is this something highlighting me? And if your scores are average or below average, it's kind of like sending a college that's test optional. Here's an average or below average letter recommendation from somebody. That's not helping you in that process. Because so remember, colleges are looking at 30 pages, literally, of factors. What's a family background? How much resources are available? What school? Yes, they look at the profile school. Have they taken any college courses? Are they in a community-based organization like Magis? Yes. And then you know this part, the grades, the type of classes, but then also they're looking at the activities, right? Family responsibility is an important activity. Think about their volunteer service, other different programs that they do. But remember, it's not the activities, the accomplishment. So remember, it's always about quality, not quantity. And then there's essays that they have to write, which I tell you, there's a lot of work. If you have a senior, tell them they cannot go out until they finish a draft of their statements. Why? Because a lot of them are not doing the homework that they need to do for each campus. So if I want to do Cal Lutheran, a campus that offers a lot of scholarship opportunities, they will have some extra writing, basically saying, what do you love about Cal Lutheran? What is great about you? What makes us great together? It's kind of like a marriage proposal. As I told my students, a prom proposal, right? You want to make it really sincere. So no bias whatsoever. The only bias is like you apply to Georgetown University or MIT or a military academy or public schools in Georgia, Florida. They require the test score. So last year we have a Magis student who's at Purdue, but this Purdue now does require the test. So if you are the class of 27, 26, 25, just check with the college. So that's why it's important to research those schools just to see, hey, are you test free? Are you test optional permanent? Remember, an Ivy League school like Columbia is permanently test optional. But if you think about it, over 2,000 schools are test optional. There's so much research that test scores does not show success later in college. Okay, is there a particular setting I need to have my son change on his score account to allow me to see and make edits for my parent account? So if there's some edits that you need to make, just you can email their assigned college counselor. Because so remember, if you have score, you have that capability of email them, please, my email's wrong. My child's legal name is not correct. I remember what I said. I said, I will give something to our freshmen and sophomore parents and guardians. And this is what we kind of also did on boot camp that we had over the summer and workshops. So when I have a workshop, it's all grade levels. This is a website that has been used by all the colleges and programs. You use Google Scorecard and look at all this information you get. Graduation rate. And the only thing is you're missing the pictures. But look, this is new information. How much money do students make after they graduate? Really important information, right? Some of it is still the same, right? The retention rate. But it's also good to give you like how many transfer, how many withdrew from the campus. Average debt. That's really important, especially if you're wonderful students thinking about going to graduate school. So this is information is not on score. What I love here about campus diversity is that they also show brand new this year, the diversity of faculty. And so that's something just to know that it's available to you. Okay. I know. Look at these questions. I love, keep them coming. Keep them coming. How can I get access to score? So I don't know what grade level you are. So if you are a senior parent, a junior parent, you have access. So just email their assigned college counselor. That's either myself, Ms. Wong, Mr. Lorenzo, Mr. Lucchese's taking over our one for wonderful Ms. Withers while she's on maternity leave. And then also Ms. Kemper Verdi. And they can resend you that invite or just have your student come in to see any counselor to send it. If you are a class of 26, come spring semester, they will send access to the score because I don't blame you. Look at all this information. And like you as a parent can see such amazing different programs. you know, for the school. It's really important stuff for looking at, you know, what the student life has to offer and programs. And then freshman parents just know that that information will be coming in the end of sophomore year. How do we get our child's class ranking for the Common App? Great question. Because guess what? Common App is going to ask, where is your child's rank is? And one of the things that you need to know is that we don't rank at SI. So there's no ranking. Your student's going to do is put down that if they're a class of 24, 372 is in the senior class. They'll put no. They'll put the GPA scale is 4, whatever the cumulative GPA. So freshman parents, your freshmen are starting their grades. It's the semester grades. And then if someone remediated a grade, your college counselor will recalculate that for you. So you could put that information on there. Okay. Keep those questions. I love it. How best can my student research scholarships available tied to schools and those that are not? So I know for a fact, anyone from last year from the class of 26, 25, 24 has this, but Miss Hernandez will let us know if our wonderful class of 27 has this. If not, by next week, they will. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Can't Stop, Won't Stop College Toolkit. And I'll tell you at the end of today's presentation what that's about. So this is something that I have collected through the years. This is also the brainchild of one of our wonderful Magis students who is at Stanford right now, says, can you just put everything in one big spreadsheet? So here you go. And this is your student has it. So you make up, but I need it. No, right now as parents, remember, and I'm speaking as a parent of 4. From all different grade levels. It's so important as they become young adults to be more of the consultant versus the manager. So have them pick one day out of the week where you could sit down, hey, let's look at the scholarships together, right? Let's make a to-do list upon the refrigerator. Here are a whole bunch of search engines where like FastWeb, you can put some information about yourself, scholarships.com, there's a long listing. There's some that are very specialized, like the Latino College Ed, MALDEF, right? Other different programs, Raise.me's partnership with different schools and scholarships. But also what I've done through the years is I have put them by quarter, 1 month with links, 1 grade level, so they could find that. But hey, don't also forget the colleges that meet full need. So if you are, you know, getting a lot of support at SI, that similar support sometimes does not continue because everyone's pocketbook, including colleges, is different. But these are schools I've done so well that if you demonstrate, even though they cost like 70, 80, 90,000, yes, some schools are 9,000 per year. I remember my first year going to SI, I had a student who went to Oberlin who was homeless and they met all full needs for that student. Room, board, tuition, books. Have you heard of Oberlin? Oberlin actually is the first school that in the nation, even though it was in Ohio, had co-ed college and also had the first college that used to be all white and then accepted individuals who identify as Black as well too. So, but there's also some schools in LA like Oxford and Pomona. Admissions rate is a lot harder at Pomona College, which also a Magis student has graduated from, versus some other schools that are on this list. How do colleges compare students who have taken the test versus who haven't? Well, they're not looking at one little thing. They're looking at the whole thing because maybe one student has a lot of family responsibilities or they have a job. One school may be a little bit picky, like school of business, nursing, engineering majors. That's where it gets particular. But if a school is test optional, they're not penalized. They're like, well, how have they prepared for us? Remember, there's a lot of research that has shown not only the test is not verify if a student's going to be successful. Is there activities they do outside of the classroom? Showing that curiosity, that letter recommendation they get from their junior, senior teacher, how much they love the class, how much they participate, raise their hand. That assigned college counselor, what's that person's character, right? Oh my God, this person has so much determination. There is no biases out there. This is a YouTube channel with, ooh, how many videos? I think there's over 80. For you, over 80. When it's time to apply and send out the application, specific colleges, should our child send it off using the appropriate application sites. Okay. OnScore, just to let everyone know, it recently allowed students to apply directly to a college campus. So if I wanted to put, you know, like, I don't know, like Chapman University, if they will have a partnership, Chapman, you could submit an application through SCORE. So if a student wants to do everything in one system, they can. The colleges don't care which system you use. But what we're recommending, since this is so new, so we may have a different statement for the class of our 26, 27, so stay tuned. But we recommend them doing the Common App. And that's what Magis is all about, working smarter, not harder. If they're applying for the Southern California College Tour, this is the application system. They're one of them that they need to fill. These are one of the steps because we want them to get ready. They're not submitting college applications, but they have a way to give access to myself or Mr. Hernandez to see it. So here shows you on this, all the various differences. There's 1,000. I mean, look, I'm still on A. How many schools? But like I said, the UCs are not on here. So your UC application, which is open right now for seniors, they could go ahead and start doing that. So it's the nice thing, it's one application for all students. If they are a Sobrino student, they could get a fee waiver. If you're like, wait a minute, I'm not Sobrino, but this is expensive, all these schools. Like, look at that, right? 560. I just saw UC Santa Barbara, how hard it was to get in. You know, and I only heard like Merced and Riverside right now are like likely campuses. So that's something that they could talk to their assigned college counselor to see if they'll be eligible for a waiver. If they're not Sabrina, Sabrina's automatic on there. And then the Cal State application, if you are a senior, starts October 1st. But at boot camp, you may have heard your freshman, I restarted my Cal State application. They have a worksheet, and this is another great website for our freshmen, parents, and guardians, and our students called californiacolleges.edu. Yes, your government, your taxes are paying for this site, not only to look about colleges, but careers, but learning about financial aid as well, too. Do you have a parent have access to see the Can't Stop, Won't Stop toolkit? No, it's geared up for the students to see because it's only for individual with the SI email. But like I said, set up that time to find that. And then definitely you could go ahead, but no, my kid doesn't talk to me. I've had those moments too. Here is one website that gives you scholarships that you can search for it. But I do recommend like, hey, you need spending money for the movies. Pick that day, 10 minutes. Let's sit down and do this together because it's important process because it's hard to sit down and do this stuff because you think, oh, I have plenty of time senior year. Trust me. Did you see how much was on, you know, that toolkit? It is a lot. Look, this is not all of it. College search, personal statement. I mean, it's a lot. Can you share tips and tools to get app fee waiver? So I think it's also on SI's website that you get 4 for the UCs. Cal State's will be 2. And then every school on the Common App will be a waived SAT, ACT waivers. So when you see this, there's a waiver. Some schools, just you apply, will give you a waiver. So if you're not Sobrino, but there's some financial challenges, if your family is not Sobrino, please reach out to their assigned college counselor because on Common App, so a college counselor who needs to answer to say, yes, I'm granting this person a fee waiver. So the student would do it here and then also on the SCORE application, but on the student end. My child doesn't know what she wants to major in. Does the module help guide her making that decision? Yeah, definitely. And also SCORE, this is a parent one, but there is a platform for students to kind of look at that information too. There's some assessment tools that students can use on their dashboard. So that's something that's available. Also, you saw here on California colleges, if you want to look at another assessment, but they want you to sit down and look. But do know, if you looked at the X account, aka used to be Twitter, yes, we do have a St. Ignatius Magis. It's okay to be undecided. All the UCs are undecided. There's just a few schools that you have to know your major. So like Cal Poly San Luis Obispo's one, Cal Poly Pomona, right? Because you start your major right away. It's colleges in Canada, most of the rest of the world does it. But the only times where I tell students that they need to know their major because it's hard to transfer into it, again, it's engineering, If they offer a school of business, if it's a direct admit for nursing, if you have to audition for visual performing arts, right? Like to be a dancer, singer, actor, and then also architecture. But there are a few other schools, like chemistry is really challenging, like for at UC Berkeley, or neuroscience. And that's where they could come in, but do not feel, I mean, there's tons of other majors. You saw UC Santa Barbara was a campus on that over there that definitely was like, oh, like most of the people were social sciences, no biggie. Because a lot of the students do general ed classes again, and then we'll build off from there. And also too, whether you use X or whether you use Instagram, go look at the colleges, right? So just to use that same example, like look at all these things that you can learn about the class for UC Santa Barbara. So that's also a way to not only have for your kid and you to figure out what it's like in the school, but also what is the social life, right? Does the school have your kids back? Does a Sabrina student get fee waivers for all UCs or only certain? Yeah, so only four for UCs. That's not our policy. That's the policy that the UCs have. So, hey, you have to have, you know, UC Merced or UC Riverside on there. Just reason why. So it, remember, they meet about 70% of full need. That's pretty good. There's a lot of schools in California who don't. A lot of our students tend to want urban, big Division I schools in popular states, and they tend sometimes not to give that much financial aid as well too. But you'll see a lot of times this can't stop, won't stop. Like you'll hear it, you'll see like videos out there, all this good stuff. And why? A long time ago, when I first came to St. Ignatius, we were at Loyola Marymount University, and a Charles Mason talked about his story as being first gen, identified as BIPOC, and how everyone just never talked to him about college. Everyone assumed him and his brothers would not go. But he always had that mentality, can't stop, won't stop, to move upward and forward in his life. And even as a professional who with a graduate degree, the first in his family, he'll put on his college sweatshirt and go around, go, hey, coach, hey, coach. And it's like, everyone assumed what he did was a coach versus him being who he is. And, you know, the message that he has sent to the students that day, the message that I have seen students from last century to this century, the message that your students, what you practice with your family, is that you can't stop, won't stop. If things get challenging on there, you need to have that mentality that you can't stop. And then you could use your resources like Magis as your parent or guardians, their peer groups who won't stop together. That's why you also hear me say a lot of time we have to move upward and forward, but together on that path. And so let me talk about other resources and then the changes that are coming up. So we remember talked about test optional. Majority of colleges do not need test scores, but it's always good to just check if a scholarship does require it from the colleges, but the majority will not. Okay, let's talk about these new changes. So yes, there's a lot of new changes. So just to let everyone know about financial aid. Yes, there's still financial aid, but there's a lot of changes coming up. And I think what I'll do is, though there's not a lot of resources, except I'll explain what that resource is in a moment, there's certain things that it's important to kind of know. So let's talk about two things. Right now, whether you are a senior parent and guardian or from the class of 2027, it's really important to not assume and find out how much colleges are. If it's a school that uses, it's an additional financial aid application called the CSS profile. That is a school to really look at and consider. I'll put that link on here. That opens up October 1st for senior parents. And why? Because these schools, is the one thing that's not changing, will consider multiple kids in college, will consider the medical expenses, will consider so many different things and look at all these different schools. Bowdoin, Boston University meets full need. Colorado College meets full need. Cornell University meets full need. Davidson College right? There's a lot of schools on, not all of them do, but a lot of them will take into consideration and even allow a paragraph of explaining certain situations. So that for senior parents opens up October 1st, and you want to finish that application no later than Halloween, because each school may say, I need, so it's always, you know, for the class of 24, they're going to ask for 22 taxes. If it's the class of 25, they're going to ask for the 23 taxes and so forth. And this is a great website that you could get an estimated figure of how much to pay for the schools. So here, they wanted something easy for families. So you're not applying for financial aid. You're just, it's kind of like they were going to the car dealership. Hey, this is how much I have. This is what I don't have. How much will you give me? All right. So it's a rough estimate. These are all schools that are very friendly of giving their money if you demonstrate need in their eyes to that campus, right? And everyone's going to be a little bit different. Like St. Olaf in Minnesota meets full need, but USC doesn't. And you'd be like, what? USC is so big. It's so, you look so expensive. You know, the buildings are, yes, I know, but every campus and institution prioritize their money differently. Right. And then, and a lot of these schools, we've had Magis students go and attend. We had a student get accepted for Williams College. Never heard of it. Williams College gives more money than Princeton, Brown, Columbia, Stanford. I'm not exaggerating. This is one of our Magis students. And they just couldn't believe it. Like, how's this school giving me more money than these other big institutions? So whether you're a freshman parent or senior, that's a tool definitely to use. So what I've told you right now is what's not changing too much for these schools. But what about all those schools that are not listed here, right? Again, this will be updated on October 1st. There's a lot of changes happening for the financial aid. Summary of the changes. So this is starting with this senior class. And this I did go over for all the students at boot camp on that Friday workshop. So one of the things that they are looking at is that they're only going to ask 36 questions. So that's great, right? Because less question, but that means less information about your needs. Now, look at this. Yes, I'll put the link. I already know there's someone thinking that right now. So I'm putting it on this from the California State Aid Commission, by the way. They're decreasing aid for middle, high income families. Remember, this is for schools you have to worry about for FAFSA only. So if you saw Lehigh or St. Olaf or Boston University, they're a CSS profile school. So they were still under consideration. But if you apply just to a UC, University of Oregon, right now I know for sure, oh, Chapman University, they are only using FAFSA. This is a concern if you fall in that category on there. But as this is decreasing, there is an increase for Pell Grant, which is geared up for low-income families. But remember, it's not low-income in the Bay Area. It's low-income for the nation. So here, you may have, if you're a veteran parent, there's no more EFC. It's called Student Aid Index to kind of show, you know, what is the amount. Also, if you are a single parent, so that still stays the same for FAFSA. If you're a single parent, they'll still look at that, but it's only the custodial parent. They'll look at that information. And this is the part that's really hard for families who have multiple kids in college. It is no longer, notice the word here, no longer considered. So if you have one kid in college, like, oh, of course they're going to give me more need. No, it really has to be more about the family size. So a small impact on low-income families with multiple children in college. That's the hard part. These are other things they'll no longer take for FAFSA form, no more looking at cash reports, and everyone must upload their tax forms that's online. Now, if you are a senior parent right now, you can go do your FSA ID number. You will create one for yourself. One for your student, and the student will create one. Please do not use their SI email, but the FAFSA form, because there's so many changes, is not going to be ready until sometime in December. They haven't even given the date. So think of it this way. Before Halloween, make sure you're, for senior parents, make sure your CSS profile is done. If it's fast, make sure that you submit it before Christmas. See if each campus has any verification information. Also, parents, guardians, you can contact financial aid if there's special circumstances. But do know if you have a special circumstance like, hey, I just had another beautiful child, or I lost my job in 20, in 23, but not 22. Some schools that are FAFSA only, it's happened to a lot of our UC candidates who got accepted, don't do the appeal until they decide May 1st, until May 1st. That's a mouthful, but on October 3rd, SI Counseling Department, we will have a presentation. But remember, if you have more questions, send them to your beautiful students. I don't care if they're freshmen, sophomore, junior, the more the merrier. So have them come. But again, your beautiful student can't do this thing called the net price calculator, right? So if you do the net price calculator at any school, let's just say it's Santa Clara, they need some guidance about what your finances are. And if you don't feel comfortable sharing it, then you make sure to take charge. If you need some help, you contact them. You could contact us. You could contact their college counselor. We can't crunch the numbers, but we could guide you through the process. So a couple of things just to remember. So for the month of September, college reps are coming to SI. Please make sure your students, if they're available up for lunch or after school, take advantage of it. Even if it's a college they don't know about it, learn, find out. They don't know a question asked, can you tell me more about your school? I've just thought I'd come in. Also, have them connect, ask about scholarships. It's always listed in the counseling department. Have them come and drop in times that's available. It's always in my door. I'm in the counseling office. But there's also the workshops most Mondays and Fridays. They're all on that Google Calendar. In October, we will have a financial aid presentation open to all families. And don't forget, because October is also our Southern California trip, please make sure that your student does all the required necessary steps. Again, on that beautiful newsletter, look at the Instagram, look at all these resources for you, whether it's over almost 80 episodes on our podcast, wherever you stream. We have videos. Your students have chats. You don't think I give them scholarships? I have to tame myself how much information I give to them. So make them download Google Chat, which is free from the Google. December 7th is that next Q&A. So please make sure that and remember, we have some students that were here in the group. Please have them come over. And do know the stress, the strain, the concern. I'm not only here as the very fortunate and lucky Magis College advisor. I'm also here as a parent who's gone through it, that with a lot of situations, I check the box, blended family, right? The kid that talks to me all the time from the kid that doesn't talk to me all the time. And that's why Ms. Hernandez is like, okay, remember, you have to end it early because I'm going to the airport to drive my kid who doesn't want me to go with him. He's a rising senior in college, a posse scholar too, which our moderators have a great opportunity of getting those support services as well. So when I give you information, I'm giving you the same information I would give to my friend, give to my own children, and I'm so blessed to give it to you. So hopefully come with your question December 6th. Please make sure to go to those other events. And then if there's any questions about, hey, they missed the boot camp, this and that, make sure your students find Ms. Hernandez to take advantage of that. And then they stop by the workshop. That's really key because we do keep track of those beautiful students. All right, I have to run to my car. I got my matcha here. I got my hope. My aspiration, this is just the beginning, people. This is just the beginning. So I'm going to sign off. No, thank you. Thank you for being here, okay? I'm going to make sure I do the speed limit. And that means we have to take it slow. Ignore the rumorville that you hear outside from everyone. I heard this. Trust what's in black and white. Because it's all about what the colleges say. That scholarship, the financial aid. But remember, the most important thing is your child, your beautiful student. Are they happy? Do they believe in themselves? And if they don't, that they're working towards that. Because that belief, that knowing I have someone who has my back, that's going to help them be innovative. That's helping them to move forward, right? I still know my students. I still talk to those Magis students who knew, hey, I messed up in high school, I could do better. And they did. They went to community college and then got accepted to all four UCs. And then I have some students that got into the big name schools, like UCLA, that didn't believe in themselves, didn't feel someone had their back for the campus, and then wasn't able to be there. Okay, I gotta go. Thank you all for your presence. Remember to smile, have fun, and even if your kid doesn't want to hug you, you hug them. Thank you so much. You gotta run. Till next time, I'll see you in December. Take care, everybody.
Thank you for listening to SI Counseling Podcast, where we help our students strive to respond courageously to the opportunities and challenges of our time.